Hi, and welcome to the Ask Dr. Angela podcast with everyone's favorite OBGYN, Dr. Angela Jones. Have you ever been too embarrassed or shy to ask your own doctor about your, you know, girl parts? Well, you've come to the right place to get straight answers. Feel free to ask Dr. Angela anything women's health related. Obstetrics and gynecology? She keeps it real. Pregnancy? She's been there, done that. Menopause? She'll get you through. Young or old, Dr. Angela's got you covered, girl. Now here's Dr. Angela.
What's good, people? This is Dr. Angela, everyone's favorite OBGYN, and I would like to officially welcome you to episode 222 of the Ask Dr. Angela podcast. So not too long ago, a couple of podcasts ago, I did an episode on, yes, your parents, grandparents are having sex. Well, in today's podcast, I'm taking that a little bit further. And guess what? Dating in the 60s. Uh-oh. Grandma's got chlamydia. But I'm going to take it a step further than that. Grandma's got gonorrhea too. So I swear I cannot make this stuff up. Literally, I saw a young lady in her 60s last week. And both she and her daughter are patients of mine. And lo and behold, you know, the mom comes in and says to me, Dr. Angela, you know, I'm seeing this new guy, but now all of a sudden I've got like this terrible discharge. It hurts. It's burning. And so, you know, I'm like, that's great. Are you having protected sex? And she's like, no, we're in a mutually monogamous relationship. And one of the things that I always ask people is, even though you're mutually monogamous, is your partner also mutually monogamous? Is your partner also only sleeping with you? That seems to be the question that we need to be asking. Well, lo and behold, turns out that her partner was sleeping with a lot of other people. You know, women of the night, women that do things for money. You know what I'm talking about. And there's no offense to these girls. I mean, I know you gotta do what you gotta do. But anyway, I said, I think that you probably should be tested for STIs. And so lo and behold, 48 hours later, I'm calling her up and I'm like, Mrs. Such and Such, you tested positive for gonorrhea and chlamydia. And so of course, you know, 20 minutes after I get off the phone with her, the daughter calls me and she's like, oh my gosh, Dr. Angela, my mom has gonorrhea and chlamydia. And I'm like, I know, I just told her. How do you think she found out? And so it leads to a very interesting state of affairs. And the reason that I bring this out is that, you know, folks in their 50s, 60s, menopause, you know who I'm talking about, the seniors living in these adult communities, they are flipping doing it. And they are doing it without protection because everyone thinks that condoms is just for pregnancy prevention. Newsflash, it is not. Condoms, really, outside of female condoms, but I mean, really, how many people do you know that actually use those? I mean, have you seen those things? It's like putting a trash bag inside of your vagina, but that's like a whole nother conversation. But anyway, condoms are like the most popular barrier method that actually helps to prevent or help you to prevent the spread of the good stuff that's not good. And I mean, you don't really need me to run the list, but I'm going to run it anyway because obviously some of you do. Gonorrhea, chlamydia, syphilis, HIV. I mean, the list goes on and on and on. So to my senior population that's listening to this, you should be wearing condoms not to prevent pregnancy, but to help to prevent you from getting gonorrhea, chlamydia, and the whole list of other things. Herpes, the gift that keeps on giving. You know, the whole list of other things that condoms help to protect against. I feel like I need to be giving these away at my office, maybe having them available in the bathrooms, because sometimes people are just embarrassed to ask. I know that in a lot of senior communities, there's a woman that I have that's like, you know, she goes around to these communities and she passes out condoms because folks are sleeping around, getting around. And there's nothing wrong with that. Just be safe. So gonorrhea, chlamydia, herpes, it ain't just happening to young folks. So be careful. And remember, protect yourself. Thank you so much for tuning into today's podcast. I'm sure it's not that much fun hearing that grandma's got gonorrhea or chlamydia, but hey, it's happening. If you have a topic or question, concern that you want presented, or answered on the podcast, you know where to reach me, www.askdrangela.com, askdrangela.com. That's where it's going down. You can sign up for my amazing blog post there. You can subscribe to the podcast, as well as our YouTube channel, which has amazing video clips that are both hilarious, as well as informative. You can direct message me on any of the social media venues, which are there on the website. That's going to be Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, or you can just directly email me. However you want to do it, I will get back to you. In closing, I want to leave you with this kind of quote from William Cowper. Actually, it's Cowper, William Cowper, and it's from my Congratulations graduate book. And I get a lot of quotes from this book because I like it a lot. And this is what he said. Never tell a young person that something can't be done. God may have been waiting for countless centuries for somebody ignorant enough of the impossibility to do that thing. And God gives to every man the virtue, temper, understanding, taste, that lifts him into life and lets him fall just in the niche he was ordained to fill. I liked that a lot, which is why I shared it with you. Thank you so much again for tuning in. It's always a pleasure. Until next time, look better, feel better, be better. Can't wait to reconnect on episode 223.
Thank you for listening to the Ask Dr. Angela podcast. For more information on women's health and the show notes for this episode, please visit Dr. Angela at www.askdrangela.com. While you're there, don't forget to leave your own message for Dr. Angela. See you soon! All of the information provided and discussed in this podcast is for educational and informational purposes only and should not take the place of consulting a physician. This podcast is not intended to diagnose, treat, or cure any disease or illness and does not and should not replace treatment from a medical professional.